feels like I've been here forever. Why can't you just intervene? Do you see the tears keep falling? And I'm falling apart at the seams.
So this is pretty much not just about miscarriage, but about my journey in life, so you guys get to join me and grieve with me, as well as share my joy. And also, I hope that you will be blessed and encouraged, and that you too will be able to put your hope in Christ alone. So just to update you guys, last week on Friday, actually, September 20th, my water broke. I was 17 weeks pregnant. I've been going to the hospital for a week prior to with lower abdominal pain. I came home. The doctors have been saying everything's fine. Baby's heart rate is fine. Everything's good. And I just put my trust in what they were saying and thought everything was good. Friday came. I was here with my daughter and my water broke. And at first I was kind of curious as, oh gosh, what is it? Is it what I think it is? I don't know if it's what I think it is. I hope it's not what I think it is. And instead of calling 911, I called my friend who has dealt with something similar. And I was just like, I don't know what to do. And at the same time, I couldn't panic because I had my little four-year-old staring at me like, what's going on? I called my husband. He left work. He was on his way. I called my mom, my sister, and they rushed to come meet me. And then I decided to call 911 because it was just, they would be dumb for me not to call, because I realized that was my water that broke. And having a child already, I know that experience. So I went to Emerge, and to make a really long story short, 2 hours later, I started bleeding, but they checked the heartbeat, checked mine, mommy and baby was fine. So, when you're 17 weeks, you have to go to ER, you can't go straight to labor and delivery. So I was in ER. They told me to come back the next day for an ultrasound, and they checked the baby's heartbeat. Well, they did the ultrasound, and when they were done, they came back and shared the sad news that the heart stopped beating. So on Sunday, the 22nd, I went into labor at my house. Contractions came. It was that feeling all over again. I can't believe I wanted to do that again. Or just the fact that I kind of forgot about that pain. But man, when it hit, oh gosh, it was painful. And you know, I was trying to stay calm. Breathing was the one thing that helped, and talking to a friend who just kept encouraging me and crying out to Jesus, like really crying out to him, because I didn't know what else to do. I just need somebody to take away the pain. And I didn't get more any medication, so it was hard. When we went to the hospital, I delivered the baby in the wheelchair, which is weird. I was on the stretcher from the paramedics, but they put me in the wheelchair, and I delivered then. And my husband ran and got the doctors, and they put me on the bed, and they finally, you know, the baby came out. I was in so much pain, but I remember looking up at my husband's face and just seeing that pain in his eyes. And there was just peace after that, and I could tell that I had an army of people, of saints, praying for me, because God was definitely in that room. And what should have been a moment of tears was just almost like it's done, because it was a 3-day process. Like Friday I found out, my water broke. They sent me home. Saturday I did the ultrasound, so I'm here with a baby in my womb that's no longer alive. Then Sunday it was just like, it's done, you know, and I was at peace with that. We cried. My husband and I are just loving on each other like never before, because, you know, I know that there's lies that Satan will tell you, and guilt that he'll make you feel like it's your fault, or you guys didn't try hard enough, or you didn't take your medication, you didn't pray hard enough. There's a lot of stuff, so every lie I had to reverse with the truth and find the word in one of them. Scripture that I hold to is 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9, which is what this blog is based on, made perfect in my weakness. And pretty much it says, you know, Paul is asking God to take this thorn out of his flesh. And God answers and says, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. And I feel stronger at this weak point, and I'm just really happy. So I pray that you guys are blessed, and we will talk tomorrow. Tomorrow will be a new day. I'm going to take you guys through just the journey when I came home and reality hit. So be blessed and continue to join me as we look to the cross, as we look to Christ at this time, whatever situation you're going through that's painful and sad and heartbreaking, just know that there is a God who loves you, and he sent his son here to die for you. And if you just believe that, you know, just believe it in your heart, you'll be saved. So take care, and thank you guys for joining me. Have a great day.